In this video on Google Earth Pro, we discuss using the Regionate tool. These videos were made possible by AmericaView, Virginia View, the Virginia Cooperative Extension, Colorado Mesa University, and Virginia Tech's College of Natural Resources and Environment. Funding for this project was provided by the United States Geological Survey under grant number G14AP00002. The contents of this video and the related written tutorial are solely the responsibility of the authors and do not represent the official views of the U.S. Geological Survey. Mention of trade names or commercial products does not constitute their endorsement by the United States government. This video accompanies Section 11 in Chapter 3 of a written tutorial titled Exploring Our Planet with Open Source Software. You can find the written tutorial at virginiaview.cnre.vt.edu/education or at americaview.org/exploringourplanet. So what is Regionate in Google Earth Pro? Well, Regionate allows you to import large data sets to make them easier to use by limiting the amount of data that's displayed depending on to what extent you're zoomed in or out. This will become clear as we use the Regionate tool. So where do we find the Regionate tool? Well, you go to the toolbar where you have the words. So once you've clicked on Tools, you're going to click on Regionate. Now, if you notice in this particular case, on this tool, Regionate does not have a box because you're not checking the box. When you click on it, you're actually going to get the tool to open. So what you need to do is you need to go find your file. This assumes that you already have the file that you want to use on your computer. Now, if you need to find any files, please refer to our other tutorials on KML files and GIS files and importing them into Google Earth. What we're going to use here is we're going to go find a file that we've already downloaded from a previous video. So first thing you want to do is you want to browse and go find the file that you want to use as a Regionate. Now remember, Regionate's looking for a large data set, going to make it easier to import. Once you've navigated to where your file is that you want to use, and in this case, we're going to use the census boundary file from 2016, U.S. County, 5,000 kilometers. Make sure it's populated in the file name and then click open. Now it hasn't opened yet. Okay, the next thing you need to do is you need to find a place to put those files, because what's going to happen, it's going to take each one of those individual counties and make it a separate file that will load into Google Earth. So the next thing you need to do is you need to browse and go find a place to put the files that are going to be extracted in the Regionate tool. Now what I've done is I've gone back to the same area where I have my files and I've just created a new folder. So I'm just going to use that new folder as the folder for the location to go for the Regionate. Select the folder, make sure it's folder name. And then as you can see, you've got all the information here within the Regionate dialog box. Now I have check open Regionate files when done, and then when you're ready, click on the word Regionate. Now it's not going to immediately produce a file because these are for large data sets, so it takes a while to process. And you will get a status bar or status box, just like you see here, telling you what your progress is. You can see now we're up to 59%. It really doesn't take that long. You just have to be patient and wait until it hits 100%. Once the Regionate tool is finished, it will automatically load into your places under temporary places in your table of contents. You can expand your Regionate results, again, just like you did in your table of contents in other videos, by expanding the caret. And you can see the very last entry that actually shows on my screen is Autauga. And that's just a county, the first name of the county. The counties are actually listed in alphabetical order, not by state name, but by alphabetical order of the county names, because this is the county file that we regionated, and this separated each one of those counties into its own individual files. Now let's just zoom in and see what happens when we use the Regionate tool. At the extent of looking at the continental United States, it's only showing a few of the counties. This is the purpose of the Regionate tool. It would take much longer to actually load if it had to include every single one of the counties in the United States within the map document window. Let's zoom in a little bit closer. You can see more counties have been populated. A little bit closer, and even more counties have been populated. Now, the information in our table of contents has not changed because all we're doing is zooming in the map document window, looking at individual counties as we zoom closer and having a larger spatial extent. Let's look at one more time, zoomed in on part of South Dakota, Black Hills, part of Nebraska, Wyoming, and Colorado. What I did this time is as I paged down in the table of contents to show you that the counties are listed on an individual basis. If you want more information with regards to the Regionate tool, Google Earth does have its own YouTube video, and the YouTube video link is seen here on the screen. This concludes our video on Regionate tool. If you have any questions with regards to this video or the accompanying written tutorial, please contact Dr. Tammy Parise at Colorado Mesa University or Dr. James B. Campbell at Virginia Tech. The email addresses are shown on the screen.